Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. If this is your first time watching us, we are Chase and Melia, and we are voice teachers. And today we are doing something a little bit different.
We, just like most other people, are loving Encanto. Our son, who's not even 2 yet, asks for it by name. He calls it Tonto, and he wants to watch it. What do you want to watch? Tonto. So we've seen it 150 times this week.
And granted, it's because we've chosen to watch it 100 times before he was even given the option. It's just that good.
He doesn't know how to find these things. We're the ones who pick the movies.
Absolutely.
Like, let's be honest.
He can turn the TV on and that's about it.
That's about it. Today we're going to be reacting to one of our favorite songs, Waiting on a Miracle. Now, this is because of Stephanie Beatriz.
Yep.
Who we loved from Brooklyn Nine-Nine. We didn't even know she could sing.
Right.
Yeah.
And we're really impressed so far. The first time we watched Encanto, I think that I had my typical reaction to Disney movies when I feel like they choose non-singers. And I was like, why did they choose so many non-singers? With the exception of, what's the cousin? Anyway,
the one that can hear
really well. We've watched it a ton, but I don't know everybody's name. Dolores.
Dolores.
Anyway, with the exception of her, because I know she is a singer, and you can tell she is
a singer.
But we were, the first time I watched it, I was a little disappointed because it felt like there wasn't a lot of, like, singers in it. You know what I mean? It felt like it was voice actors.
Disney can tend to choose actors who can kind of sing rather than singers who can actually sing.
And it kind of led us down the path of old school Disney when they used to do voice actors and singers, and it was two separate people to make a character voice because, I mean, nobody cares at this point if the same person is doing it. But I understand now, after watching it many, many times and knowing it very, very well, many times, I have a huge respect and appreciation for Stephanie Beatriz, and I feel like she is doing a phenomenal job. And so I'd love for us to watch this and point out some of the things that we think she is doing so well.
And like I said, I'm just really impressed with the song. This
Absolutely.
Is all her.
All her.
And I can't wait to get into it.
Absolutely. Let's get started.
Don't be upset or mad at all. Don't feel regret or sad at all. Hey, I'm still a part of the family, Madrigal. And I'm fine. I am totally fine.
I already have to stop it.
So, that's pretty good.
So the speak singing is something that's really tough. And a lot of people do, like, they call it the whisper singing. And she's emoting here. But the third time she starts like with that kind of speak singing and goes straight into it in one breath. You know,
and it's all about her airflow. And I mean, we say vowels because it is about vowels, but more specifically, it's so spoken, right? Mm-hmm. Like, yes, I'm still a part of the family, Madrigal. Yeah. And she's speaking it. It's almost exactly like she would say it. She just adds a little bit more air and pitch, which we have pitch to our voices when we're speaking. So it's not even like that different.
Yeah.
And it just is so nice and natural. Yeah. And I can understand even my first impression how it was not necessarily impressive. Because I wouldn't say so far this is like, oh my gosh, the most fantastic singing I've ever heard. But what this is it's very good technically.
Oh yeah.
Especially for somebody who I believe is not a singer first. I think she might be a singer in some capacity.
I don't think that is her first art form.
Yeah, I think she's an actress. Sure. So, but anyway.
Yeah. I loved our whole philosophy is that speaking and singing are fundamentally the same. And so for her to kind of, I even have an exercise where I, you know, I'll read lyrics or, you know, the text, and I'll go back and forth from speaking to singing just within the same line. And if you've ever tried that, it's really hard to do.
Mm-hmm.
I'm still a part of the family, Madrigal. And you have to stay really nice and loose because most people, they just try to speak one way and then they say, no, I'm singing, and they sing a completely different way.
Right.
If that's your artistic choice, that's fine, but that's not actually how your voice would naturally sound.
Right.
And that's kind of our whole deal.
Absolutely. So. And it just, I think that this is some of the best singing that I'm hearing in Disney movies. And that doesn't necessarily, and it's funny because even saying that out loud, that can mean two different things. Like, do I think she is the best singer I've heard? No, I don't think she's the best singer I've heard.
Sure.
But this singing is some of the best singing I've heard in Disney movies, because I feel like we watch a lot of even old Disney. Our favorite is Tangled, and Tangled's Mandy really Moore good. Is fantastic. Mandy Moore's fantastic. But Mandy Moore, that'll be for another day. Maybe we'll do a whole Disney series.
But we'll say even Dolores is our favorite voice in this.
She is a beautiful voice.
We wish she would sing more, or she had more songs in Encanto.
But this is good singing. Yeah. This is just really good singing. So
Stephanie Beatriz absolutely killed it.
Absolutely killed it. 1,000% killed it.
So I want to listen to that one. Listen for her transition from speaking to singing and how fluid it is. You know, you have to be really loose for that.
Hey, I'm still a part of the family, Madrigal.
Just adds air.
And I'm fine. I am totally fine. I will stand on the side as you shine. I'm not fine. I can't move the mountains. I can't make the flowers bloom. I can't take another night up in my room waiting on a miracle.
I want to talk about, if you've ever heard her speak in person, her voice has a very nasal quality.
Sure.
And so all of this sounds supernatural to what I'm used to hearing her say
and speak.
Supernatural.
Whoa.
I can't heal what's broken. It's so nice placement. And I think what I want to talk about with that too is, like, yes, this was written for her, so it was written probably for her range. It's probably, like, you know, it's customized for her,
and this is a studio recording, you know.
But I feel like how she is navigating that specific spot of her register is really nice, because she's not, like, trying to make it something it's not, you know. It really does just sound like she is allowing it to sit in a bit of a nasal kind of heady place that I think a lot of people would avoid, and I don't think she's avoiding it.
Well, I think,
and I like that.
You know, and we've talked about this in other videos, but if, you know, we've never done a Disney react, so there we might have some new people here. Nasal singing gets a really bad rap because a lot of people do it because all of a sudden it feels easier and you feel, you know, you feel really good, and, you know, it's it's ketchup. You can have too much. You can absolutely have too much.
No,
but most people don't. Most people don't have enough.
Right.
And nasal singing, you know, when you sing with a more nasal resonance, it's efficient.
Yep.
It's full. It fills a room. It cuts over a band mix or other music.
Or,
you know, it's really clear and bright and nice.
It sits nice too, even just in the frequencies, because that's the thing we talk about a lot.
It makes it easier. Yeah.
It's efficient. Like, the actual sound that you are making is more efficient. It sits nicely in the other things that are going on, even if it's a studio or live recording. Like, there's just physics to sound.
Yeah. And how voices cut through
that,
cut through all the other noise, is with a little bit of ping. We call it ping.
And we also call it, like, I mean, if you're going to get technical, it's like the timbre, right?
Yeah.
The timbre of her voice.
Yeah.
And I would say she has a pretty nasal timbre to her voice, even when she's speaking.
Absolutely.
And I love that you hear
that.
And
we mean it in a good way.
Exactly.
It's efficient.
It's very efficient.
It's nice. It's
and
full.
I would say it probably comes pretty natural to her. And I love that she's not, like, avoiding it.
Because most people sing, oh, I can't
or
heal
even Disney,
what's broken.
I even feel like Disney princessy. This isn't very typical Disney princessy singing, and
super.
I like that, because I can't move the mountains.
Where it's,
you know,
like,
what I mean?
And floaty kind
she brings, because you can also hear too, like, her voice kind of cracks when she's almost, like, crying, like,
oh, sure.
And it just sounds really,
I think it's a character choice.
Natural, totally a character choice, but I feel like it's still just, it just further proves that she's just allowing her voice to be in
what
a natural
is, to
spot.
Sound,
yeah,
sound like what it is, and that's, you know. We're talking a lot about vocal philosophy today, but that's what we believe. We think that your voice is going to sound the best if you sing how you talk,
how
if you
talk.
Just do it naturally, where your voice naturally lies.
Yep.
You know, most people are going to, I can't heal. But if I just do it like I'm talking, I can't heal.
Yeah.
One is so easy for me.
Right.
The other one, you know, wouldn't be able to fill a room with that. People
also,
in the back row aren't going to be able to hear
it. It's going
to
sound the best that you'll sound, because it is your sound, you know? So
you're not trying to sound like anything else.
Well, and I think we're going to just continue to say this over and over again, because we've been so impressed.
That's what we do here.
Well, and we've just been so impressed specifically with this movie. It's another reason we choose to keep watching it.
100 times.
It's wonderful.
We love Tonto. And
we
watch
love
it
Tonto
all the time.
So much.
I can't heal.
You could even hear like shine like all of you shine.
Yeah, there was a little, and little just, vocal break
yeah,
there.
Yeah, and I mean that's something that I just think, I don't know, I really enjoy that choice that she's making because it feels, it just feels really natural. It doesn't feel like there's a lot of stuff that she's trying to do.
Yeah.
Like I, you really, if you haven't heard her speak, if you've never heard her voice, and the only reason I say this so much is because it is very different than Brooklyn Nine-Nine. Like when she's in Brooklyn Nine-Nine, she's playing a character that is very much not who she is in person, and that's how her voice sounds. And so I cannot get over the fact that her singing sounds almost identical to her speaking.
To her speaking
and
voice.
That is such a wonderful and refreshing thing.
Oh, yeah. You know? Somebody not making some sort of weird voice up. And
it's not a character voice.
And then trying to stick to it throughout the whole thing. It's,
absolutely.
It's tough.
And I really respect like Lin-Manuel Miranda and, you know, the producers for allowing her to be that and not create a character voice.
Sure.
Because we will react at some point to surface pressure.
Yeah.
Because we do believe there's a character voice being created there.
That
is feels unnecessary.
Yeah,
because it feels like you can still accomplish the same character without putting on such heavy, I don't know. We'll talk about that in a different video. All I want to say.
I hope all you just checked your phones because that's
I know,
what I do.
Because it was ours.
Yeah, it's ours.
We're just super impressed with what she's doing from a vocal perspective and a singing perspective. I think the last thing I want to talk about just from those last few phrases is she's got a lot of great air flow and air support. It's one of the things I've heard consistently through.
Quick phrases with this. You don't have a
absolutely.
Big break. You, miracle, and then you go straight back into it.
And there's a
it's
lot
gotta
of
be tough
like,
to do live, for
and
sure.
And the melodies go up and down pretty quickly. And I feel like she's doing a great job just sending her air all the way through the phrases, allowing it to connect. There's a really nice legato, which just gives her a beautiful, like, efficient sound, like resonance, you know? There's there's a really nice resonance that you're hearing in this, like,
studio,
spoken Disney song.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's
mm-hmm.
like, I know where it sounds like we're talking about something really, like, I don't know, not a Disney movie.
Yeah,
but we are talking
know.
About a Disney
we
movie,
love,
okay?
We love talking about singing, and we've
absolutely.
Honestly been talking about the voices that we're
Tonto.
Hearing in Tonto for a while. And I think it's, you know, it's a lot of fun because we love to dive deep in this stuff. And then we always think about like, okay, how would I sing that?
Right.
And I don't, you know, I know the first thing that sticks out to me in terms of approaching this as a song I would sing is the breath. Where do you breathe?
Absolutely.
You know, there's nowhere to breathe. And she does it super quick. And like, you know, maybe she's doing it in different takes or whatever. We don't need to talk about that. But let's say you're doing it live. You have to really be intentional about taking
a good
quick breath, but also not going, you know, because that's the other thing.
Absolutely.
If you need a good quick breath, you need to relax, open it up, drop your belly.
Absolutely.
Good to go.
Yeah.
But
absolutely.
It's tough. Okay.
The vowels.
Exactly.
All
the vowels.
All I need is a chance. Yeah.
Exactly. Open your eyes. Open your eyes.
They're such nice vowels.
It is super bright, super forward, and it's good. It's a good
so
thing.
It's so good.
And I'm sure, you know, if you've ever tried this, it sounds too bright to your own ears.
Mm.
But take a recording of yourself and see if it sounds too bright.
I would love to interview her or see an interview where she talks about her voice because I wonder if she has learned to love it being a more nasal voice. You know what I mean? Because it's exactly like you said, like to yourself, it probably sounds really intense. Like, and we all have that. And so I would just love to know if it's something that she's learned to embrace because it sounds like she has.
Yeah.
And maybe she's always loved
it. She's leaning into it.
You know, maybe she's always loved her voice, but her voice is so unique in its quality and timbre. And I just think it's really cool to apply it to singing and this character. It's just been really nice to hear.
Oh, yeah.
So cool.
I think that the nasal efficiency, nasal resonance gets such a bad rap that I just want people to listen to this and think, I should be brighter
I
and more
be
nasal.
Brighter.
Give it a try. Give it a try.
Yeah, absolutely.
Someone please just let me know where do I go. I am waiting on a miracle.
broken, broken.
Yeah.
She, you know, you don't have to be broken. And oh, is a really tough one for me.
Nice.
I swallow it super quickly.
Mm-hmm.
I can heal what's broken. It's super full and easy. She's talking and adding air.
Exactly. She's literally speaking.
It's awesome.
And just with more air.
New and do. Mm-hmm. A lot of people go new and do, right? New, do, front of your teeth. I tell some students to aim for the back of your teeth. Try to keep everything on this side of your mouth. You know, mm-hmm. the front part of your mouth is where everything, you know, you want your sound out.
Out, yep.
You know, the more you keep your sound here and feel it and like, you know, kind of sing to yourself, the less that sound is getting out.
Yep.
And you want to have, I mean, it's awesome to have a big voice. It's awesome to have a voice that fills a room. It's, it's a magical thing.
I also want to talk about, we talk about this a lot. She's not letting these kind of consonant heavy wordy phrases getting in the way of that airflow. So what can I do? So what can I do? Like she just, you know, I can't even, let me think of an example. Oh, here we go. I am waiting on a miracle. You know, she just lets it, I am waiting on. Like,
she's not
am waiting,
on these.
Yeah. It's, she doesn't get stuck on these consonants where mm-hmm. they sit. She allows for them to be there so you can understand the word, but she moves forward through it. And
she's
it sounds.
Hopping from vowel to vowel.
Vowel to vowel, which is all of that legato that I talk about. That's why it sounds so nice and
easy.
And it continues to keep the resonance, even though it's kind of some wordy phrases.
Yeah.
I've been really impressed with that.
If you're not like super prepared on this, I can imagine it starting to sound frantic because there's a lot of words and you're trying to catch your breath
and
you're also trying to move around, you're trying to have dynamics, you know.
Mm-hmm.
it can be one of those songs that gets away from you.
Absolutely.
And, you know, but if you prepare, if you keep it easy, hop from vowel to vowel,
mm-hmm.
and you're just speaking, you know, it might be
a lot
easier to stay cool.
And it's funny, all of these things that we're saying sound really simple, like duh. But it's actually a lot harder than it sounds. Like, doing this well is difficult. This is a difficult thing to do, and she is doing it very well.
Yeah.
This is not easy, you know? I mean, it seems easy, but I think that's anything that you perfect. You work really hard to get good at it. And
I like to say it's simple,
it's
but it's
simple,
not easy.
But it is not easy.
Simple,
absolutely.
Not easy. Okay, that's my favorite part.
Me too.
But I have to go back.
Yes.
Because
chills.
I'm ready. So I'm ready. I've been patient, steadfast, and steady. I is a song, or is a word you sing a lot. A lot of people go, I. I.
Mm-hmm.
Do you say, who's, you guys ready to go? I am.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I am. You know, maybe you do, but I wouldn't recommend it, you know. You say, I am.
Mm-hmm.
I'm ready. I'm ready. Why aren't you ready? I'm ready. Well, sing it like that.
Yeah.
Sing I'm ready. I'm ready.
Exactly. It sounds like she's kind of like yelling it, like declaring it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yes, there's pitch and tone and she's obviously singing, but the ease of what she's doing is just so spoken. It's so natural.
Yeah.
I also just love her. I mean, obviously this is a animated character, but you can still feel her energy.
Yeah,
right?
Totally.
Like you can feel the energy in this part.
Well, I think that's
vocally.
Good voice acting too.
Absolutely.
And like, I think Pixar Disney
of
does
course.
A really good job of, I believe they film the voice acting and then try to incorporate that in the animation.
I'm sure that's
because
part
it's
of it.
Natural and I think it makes it look more natural.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. She doesn't even breathe. Like, no. Okay, she does breathe. She breathes, "When you gave us a miracle." Most people are going to hit that note really hard. Mm. And she might have, you know, and they fixed it up in the studio.
I mean, this is definitely not live, yes.
"When you gave us a miracle." For her to have the looseness and the vibrato up top there, mm-hmm. I just think it's a really awesome and very... That would be tough.
And I think
that's a tough thing to sing.
There's something to be said, too, about the vowel she's choosing there mm-hmm. and she creates, because it's a bit nasally. And that vowel typically wouldn't be like, "When you..." How does it go?
"Gave us a..."
"When you gave us a miracle." Mine is not as miracle. She has more of...
Should maybe do that more.
A nasal, like it, and that's what I'm saying. Like, she's kind of opening my eyes a lot vocally because she's doing some things that I wouldn't typically like think of doing.
Yeah.
Like to nasalize an vowel.
Well, and that was the other thing. A lot of people are gonna go, "Miracle." Don't do miracle. Right. Don't sing on an L, right? She sings on the vowel, "Miracle." Mm-hmm. And the L is right at the end there.
Yeah, totally.
But like when go back to what you were saying, I'm sorry.
No.
When you sang there's a harmonic.
Yes.
So if you don't know what a harmonic is, you have your pitch, the pitch that you're singing, mm-hmm. and you have other pitches
yep.
that are at different intervals above that. And that's kind of what makes up sound. We're not just overtones. One single,
yeah.
you know, little pitch or frequency. We're a bunch yeah. and they're overtones. And when you open up different like resonance mm-hmm. things,
use different
yeah. vowels, all that kind of stuff, different harmonics are created. So,
yes.
So when you add this stuff, there's some sort of crazy high, like, you know,
exactly.
that, and that's what cuts.
Yes.
That's what kills. That's what just is like, you hear that over everything, and it's so vibrant and
right.
alive, and I love it.
It makes amazing. Me so nerdy yeah. excited
oh my gosh.
Because it's like, there's a reason. It's like, it's science, right?
Yeah.
Like, this isn't something that, like, there's a reason we talk about vowels, and yes, we talk about it in a pretty general sense, like a generic sense.
Yeah.
We're not talking about the science behind it, but I think it makes me so nerdy excited because there is science behind it. Like, 100%. This isn't just something that we made up. Like,
no.
Vowels are important.
I mean, it's actually, it's called the singer's format.
Exactly.
And we have books on it.
And
I mean,
people study it.
People study it.
And it is physics of sound.
Yeah.
There is, you know...
It's how it works.
Yes. If you were an audio engineer, if you were, you know, somebody that deals with, like, actual physics of sound.
Or really, really treated your ears.
Yeah.
Or, done a lot of ear training to identify certain frequencies.
Absolutely.
You'd hear it.
You know these things.
In a second. Yeah.
And so it's just, this gets me excited because it feels like for one of the first times, maybe the first time ever, we're hearing this in mainstream, like, that's what I hear when I listen to this.
Yeah.
I hear somebody who is taking singing seriously in the sense that singing is speaking. Like, you know what I mean? Like, this is very simple.
But maybe that's just how she approaches
it,
you know?
It, yes.
Maybe it's just her.
Maybe
just
it is.
Just the way Stephanie... It's just Stephanie Beatrice being,
you're right, because
being amazing.
Being great.
Being great.
It. I mean,
see,
obviously,
I don't
though...
know. Maybe you can tell we're fans.
I've seen this movie too many times. And I do love it so
stayed up late
much.
Nights having long talks about how wonderful Stephanie Beatrice is.
I've
both
become
on
obsessed.
And singing... In Tonto.
And you guys might find that funny too, especially if you've watched our other videos and we've talked about other people who are making careers as singers and we've been less than impressed potentially
sure.
in our video, depending on which one you're watching
sure.
and being so impressed by this. But I think that if you really understand our philosophy and what we're talking about and what we feel passionate about,
it's not ours.
With
we didn't
singing,
make it up either.
No,
I mean,
no, no.
It's, you know, it's something that we've adopted.
Absolutely. But I just mean like what we feel passionate about with singing
yeah.
and why, then maybe you'll also be as excited about this because this is, I don't know. It's exciting. It's exciting.
I think it's cool.
I think it's cool.
And I really love, I just love nerding out on singing.
Absolutely.
And hopefully you do too.
Absolutely. That's why you're watching it.
If you love nerding out on singing as much as we do, please be sure to hit that subscribe button and the notification bell if you would like to see more of our videos. We make new videos like this every week. We're always talking about singing and getting super excited about
yes,
singing.
Yes, nerd alert.
And hopefully helping you and helping ourselves learn more about singing.
Absolutely. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and we will see you next time. I will never get enough of this movie.
That's awesome.